Hello, 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 hello. God bless you. God keep you. God bless all the people that are attending church right now. I'm not going to be able to make it. My Blues Clue, that's what I'm going to start calling my car, Blues Clue. It gives me the blues and I don't have a clue why. Oh, Lord. Woo. It don't hurt to laugh. So, I'm going to tune in to Bates Memorial 12 o'clock service. I don't know who will be preaching, but it doesn't matter. I just need a word. Need a word to carry me through next week. Because whether it's up or whether it's down, I'm still going to work. I pray for each and every one of you. And God bless you for going to church, showing up and showing out. Like I said, I'll be attending online to God be the glory. You know, yesterday I sounded gloomy. And like I said, what I'm eventually do is I'm going to take a break because I'm tired of whining and complaining and happy one minute down the next. You know what I'm saying? All that crazy stuff. So I'm just going to wait and just be about it instead of talk about it because I feel that I'm talking too much. And I don't even want to hear myself talk no more. I'm tired of hearing me talk. So probably this will be my last video for a period until I get on my feet. God puts me on my feet until I can come back with something positive, 100% positive to say. You know, a hallelujah breakthrough praise moment. Because really I don't have anything to talk about. You know, God is good all the time. And my desire, my goal is just to tell people about his goodness and His grace and his mercy. And I looked at my life last night. Like I said, I had a heart-to-heart talk with God last night. I've been talking to a period. And I can't see that what I'm saying on these videos is helping anybody. You know, I don't get responses to these videos because it's YouTube. So, but I can't see that I'm helping anybody. You know, I'm just talking, you know, and I'm rambling on, you know, and my whole purpose is to help somebody come to Christ. And so I'm not doing this, so what's the purpose in keep talking? And especially talking about one minute I'm walking, then I'm riding, one minute I'm walking, then I'm riding. I don't, that's no praise in that. Who wants to come to Christ listening to somebody bitching and moaning all the time? Yes, I said it, but B-I-T-C-H is a dog, so hello. So, I mean, who wants to hear me constantly talking about, oh, I'm up and then I'm down, sound like I'm crazy. And so I'm not, you know, I used to be. That's another story. I'll tell you about that testimony because, like I said, I've been walking with him a long time and I'm not tired yet. And so, like I said, I'm not going to get out here no more and talk about, you know, I mean, if I got something really praise report, yeah. But to get out here and then next time it's a down situation, nah, I'm not doing that. So, like I said, I'm going to take me a week break so I can get back on my feet so I can stay focused. I need to stay focused. And I need to be about it and stop talking about it. You know, I don't want to hear me talk no more. I'm tired of hearing me talk. You know, I've been talking too loud. My whole summer's gone. I didn't enjoy my summer. So, like I said, I didn't do the things I wanted to do. That's a whole summer gone. And so, no, I'm not going to sit here and keep on complaining. The next time you hear me, it'll be a praise report. You won't hear from me ever again. So God bless you and keep you and keep your head up and keep God on your mind. And don't let my walk and my talk discourage you from God. Because like I said, what he has for me, he has for me. And I know that it's a whole lot of storms right now. I know it's like a Hurricane Katrina in my life right now. Now I didn't experience the death. And you know what I'm saying? I'm not taking lightly because what those people went through is traumatic. I work with a person, you know. Couple of years ago they had went through that, you know, seeing bodies floating. So no, I don't take it lightly, but I'm talking about horrific. And that's what my grandbaby said, it was horrific. I said, go ahead out. So horrific experiences, you know, seeing something just devastating that will be with you the rest of your life, especially children experiencing that. My prayers always go out to those families and to their state, this, you know. So like I said, I don't take things like that lightly. It's 11:57. Like I said, you probably won't hear from me again. But like I said, my whole goal and whole purpose for this was just to bring people to Christ. That was all I was trying to do. I was just trying to tell people. and it seemed like it got away from me. And I know the devil plays a part in everything, but like I said, when the breakthrough comes, I come back and talk. And if a breakthrough doesn't come, you know, if I don't get a new car and if this car doesn't get repaired, I have learned a lesson. And I'm gonna share that with you real quick right here. The devil this is one of the things he does with me. He knows that my will is strong, but God's will says, sit down, let me take it. But my will wanna say, nah, I'm gonna keep putting into that car and get it. And see, I learned a lesson because I kept doing that. And that was my will. So God's will is let it set. I'm gonna do what I gotta do when I finish with church. I'm gonna go ahead and go walk. If my son doesn't come and pick me up, I'm gonna go ahead and walk out here and go to the place, to the store, and get the parts, and then I will repair the car myself. Although he slayed me, and I don't like saying it no more. Brother God, God has done, he done more than enough. And I used to hear people saying, I'm like, yeah, right, you don't have this, you don't have that, oh, you're homeless, whatever. But now I'm learning. Being in this storm and in this situation and in this moment right now, I understand what people are saying when people are blind and people are deaf or people have cancer and different illness. I understand now when they say they still love God. I really do. Like with my mother, she has Alzheimer's, she can't see, but she still has God on her mind. And I understand when you got that past. When you have that past with him, and you know, when I say I don't have a friend, and I said that last night, I do have a friend. I have a friend in God. Jesus is my friend, and he's the best friend in the whole wide world, you know, that understands me. I don't understand him. I don't understand him, but I love him, and I don't have to understand him to love him. But I know what he's brought me through, and I know when I was on my back and I was sick, I know that he was there. I know he healed my mind, you know, and I will forever be grateful for that. And I know with him doing those things, that's why I can sit back, and I thank people, you know, I hope it didn't scare people when I say, I don't care if I die, if I don't get what I want, I die. I walked with him too long. I love him enough that I would love to be with him. I'm not going to kill myself, hello. But the journey's been beautiful. It's been let me take it back. Knowing him has been beautiful. There was times when I was left in the storm, when I was doing devices and things of my own, and I thought I was happy, but I was miserable. Ripping and running the street, laying and sleeping with different people and all that type of thing with different men. You know, I thought, hey, I'm doing something. But I realized I wasn't doing nothing. All I was doing was harming myself and harming other people and hurting people and making enemies. Making a lot of men enemies, you know what I'm saying? For real, you know. So I haven't lived that life for a long period of time. And I thank God for that. You know, I thank God for that. You know, 7 years I've been sober. And it's been some ups and it's been a lot of downs. And it's been time, like I said the other day, and when I broke down. But I still don't want to go back to not being me. When I was drinking and doing all kind of running the streets and laying with different people, I wasn't being me. And not being me, I was unhappy. I was miserable. But I would drink to cover up the misery. Sleep with one person on to the next. What? I had all my little cliches, you know. What? Dude, what you won't do for me, another one will. Bye. See you. Wouldn't want to be you. forgive me, man. I was laughing, but it was at the time I was. Lord help me, Jesus. You know, God had his hand on me. Oh, Lord, I would say stuff to people. I dated guys 6'2", 6'3". I'd be talking cash smack. And they wouldn't even say nothing to me. They definitely didn't put their hands on me. They're like, she's a nut. She crazy. Oh, no. Like messing with her. But I miss relationships. I miss relationships. I had some good relationships. But I showed up. I was in it. And when I was in it, me and my Coke 45, oh, no. It didn't work every time. So, like I said, I've been walking with God. I've been walking with him a mighty long time, you know. And I already know for all of this, you know, I heard T.D. Jakes. I know y'all like, oh, T.D. Jakes. But he, you know, I had been listening to him, like I said, forever. But like he said, if the devil don't, when I was drinking and running the streets and sleeping with people, I didn't have all of it. Please. The car broke down. Dude, what? Can you fix my car? Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. How you doing? Yeah. Somebody fixed that car. So some money came. Mm-hmm. Yes, sir. Mm-hmm. Yes. Because I'm a lady. But now, yeah, things was flowing. But it's like now I'm trying to do right. I'm trying to do better. I don't like right, because what is right? You know what I'm saying? So I'm trying to do better. You know, I'm trying to do better. I'm trying not to. I'm putting the old man away. That's what I like to say. I'm putting the old man away, because that's what I'm doing. I put the old man away, and I'm trying to put on a new person. I'm trying to put on a person pleasing to God. And so what I was doing wasn't pleasing God, and I was unhappy. So, yeah, you know, so, yeah, I've been with him a long time, you know, and so it doesn't matter. But for the devil to put so much on me and all of these things, and I mean, he, whoo, you know, I don't like the, just evil, just things like that, all kind of things been popping off, and, you know, like you said, your enemy, TDJ, he said, your enemy knows more about where you're going than anybody. Not more than God, but more than the people around you or the people you involved with. And so for him to be coming at me, it's got to be a blessing that God's getting ready to do for me. It's some reason that you're scared. But at the same time, when I'm pulling away, I'm not saying I'm moving away from God and all of this or that. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to keep talking about it. But I know right now I need to pull back and get refocused, because something's wrong when you keep repeating. You know, I heard somebody say lower bar, whatever. You know what I'm saying? I'm in the valley too much, you know, and I don't like being there, because you can become depressed like that, and I don't have time for depression. So I don't want to, you know, how would this happen? I don't like talking about it, because to me, when you talk about what you're going through, you know, to me it gets bigger, and the devil likes using it that. So that's why I don't like talking about what I'm going through. And I don't like people talk, you know, I don't like talking about what you getting ready to do, where you getting ready to go. I've never liked that, especially when my dude used to do it, which I'm sorry I changed now. But I don't like doing that, because it opens the door for the enemy. Okay, well, she getting ready to go here, she getting ready to do that, you know, except for me getting ready to go to the store. So, he, you know, just pray to God I don't get hit, because there's no sidewalks around here. But, like I said, I want to get focused. I need to get focused and get my path straight, you know, and see what God wants me to do and what he's saying, you know, because I've been getting busy. And T.D. Jakes said another thing that always plays in my mind and has been playing in my mind the last couple of days. We can get high. I can get high on church, you know, because I was popping here and I'm popping down. Anytime somebody's church door opened, I was ready to be in it. And so I need to kick back and look at that. I need to look at that. Why am I trying to keep running up and running around? You know, I'm not saying I'm over godly and I'm doing too much God, but I need to sit back and focus on having a nice time. I need to do that too. I need to take care of me. God got me, but I need some enjoyment. You know, he came that I might have life and have life more abundant. And I don't need to pop in everybody's church, and I don't need to keep running around to church like that. You know, I need to stay focused, and I need to learn to be more friendly toward people. And brother, people extend their hands to me. See, that's what I'm saying. See, when God sets me down, he talks to me, and he let me know, stop it, Janice. You know, your behavior, change it. And like I said, I'm working on it, and I tried to change it yesterday, as a matter of fact, and the people moved away from me. But I really, that didn't bother me. I still sat where I sat. I'm not with all of that crunched up, you know. But their path is their path. I looked at that. Their path is their path. So it doesn't bother me. And because what I'm learning too, the devil does that. He wants to get in my head and get in my thoughts and tell me, oh, don't nobody want to be bothered with you. Ooh, you're an outcast. No, I'm never an outcast. I don't care if nobody ever talks to me. Oh, yes, I would love to have a conversation with an individual, a nice gentleman, a friendly lady, which I do every now and then. I speak to different people. But if I don't have it right now, I'm fine with that, because God comforts me. you know, and in due time, he will. He'll send somebody for me to talk and somebody that I can be comfortable with. But other than that, I don't let the devil bite me. He tried to do that to me the other day. And as soon as I didn't bite into it, because I knew what it was, when I didn't bite into it, it went away, you know. And so that's what I pray that people do. Watch people around you. Watch how the devil uses things. Watch how he comes across. Just watch his patterns. And like I said, perfect example, let me get on this subject and let me get off of her. One of his patterns with me is, like I said, I'm let the car be broke down again. Because what happened was, as I was taking a long ride to work, the belt broke. And this is how good God is. Oh, Lord, I do have a testimony. He didn't break the whole belt. He didn't allow the whole belt to break, because if the whole belt would have broke while I was driving on the highway, hello, be dead. Somebody else could have died. But it's one piece of belt on there. One piece of belt is left on there. And by that one piece of belt being on there, I can take, and when I add the other belt, I already have my pattern, so I don't have to worry about looking at the little paper. So, but like I said, God's good. And that's why I said, you can't make me doubt him, because I know too much about him. So, nah, like I said, I'm stepping back. I'm not running. I'm not cowardly. I was reading this guy's shirt, and this is how good God is, too. I was reading the back of this guy's shirt that was sitting in front of me, and he said, the back of his shirt said, fear tastes like chicken. And I just sat there, and I said, yeah. And I know that's God telling me, don't quit, you know, don't quit. And that's why I let people know, you don't have to sit in church all the time to get a message. If God want to speak to you, he would speak to you through all kind of things, big billboards, through TV or whatever. That's how he does me. He speaks to me, and he lets me know where I'm at. And like I said, I did. I want all my cars down. I don't want to do this, and I don't want to do that. But God's teaching me that what you made of, what are you made of, you know? And I don't have to have that car. I need to do what I got to do. You know, I got to keep doing it. And so I'm going to keep doing it, you know, and I'll find a way to get back and forth where I need to get to. You know, God bless me yesterday. I got through and did the things I wanted to do, and it was awesome. And so I'm just going to leave it in his hands. But like I said, I'm going to step away. And like I said, the part of the focus thing, like I said, I need to learn to take and be more friendly to a people, extend my hand. Even if somebody don't, I need to get out of that. Oh, you hurt me, and therefore I'm not going to, you know. But like I said, I will extend myself. If God wants me to, I will. I get up and I go and be more friendly toward people, you know. But like I said, I know he's working on me, and he's changing some things about me. You know, a lot of times I need to be more friendly. And like I said, I am. A lot of times, just certain people you're friendly to, they just, I don't know. You know, I met a lady at work. She's cool. She's younger. And she's cool. She's on a different path, but she's cool, you know. But what I've learned, I don't. So I break my neck to bond, you know. Speak, be kind, be nice. Mama said, be hospitable, you know. And then go on about your father's business, and that's what I try to do. But like I said, one day at a time. God bless you and keep you. It's 12:11. It should be starting now. Let me see if it's on. Oh my God, it's not on. What happened? They're not having church today. Is today Wednesday? Yeah, today's Wednesday because it was garbage day. So it should be church. Bam! Yes! Bases on. The power of endure. Interesting. Okay. I'm going to talk to you all later. I need a word to carry me through the rest of some of them people was tripping. 12 hours. I do 12 hours a day. By God's grace and mercy, yes. So God bless you. Keep you. I pray that the rest of your week is wonderful and successful. I pray that although you go through trials and tribulations, I pray that you remember that God cares for you. And he does. And he has grace and mercy that he can bestow on you at any given time, especially if you're awake and you're alive, then he already has. So, ta-ta now. Ta-ta.